So we have seen different representations for the spread of the data, and sometimes people use this one also as a representation of the spread in their data. The standard error of the mean. You all love this thing because it gives the smallest error bars. So there's nothing wrong with the standard error of the mean. I love it too, but it's not a representation of the spread in the data. It's a representation of how well you have measured the mean in your data. And I will try to explain this. So suppose that this is your population. And whatever it is, normal or not normal, it will have a center somewhere. And let's say the center is 5. Now, I'm doing an experiment, and I'm taking 10 individuals from this population, randomly. So I will get 10 measurements, and in many cases, the mean of these 10 measurements will be close to 5. But I can also be unlucky, and I can draw 10 individuals from this part of the population. And then I get a mean here on my measurements that is much bigger than 5. So it's not a good representation of the population. I do the same thing, but this time I take 30 individuals randomly. So when I take 30 individuals, I have to be really unlucky for all 30 of them to come from here, this part of the population. So when I take 30, I will have more chances that they will be equally spread over my population and not all coming from one of my tails. So when I take 30 measurements, I have a better chance that the mean of these 30 measurements is close to 5. And that's exactly what the standard error of the mean represents. It represents how well the mean of your experiment represents the actual center of the population. How do you calculate it? Again, I have to show a formula here. You calculate it based on n. That's what we explained here. The more measurements you take, the higher n, the better the mean will represent the actual population center. And it also depends on the spread in your population. If you have a really spread out population, then you have a higher chance of having all measurements from a tail. When you have a very narrow population, then you have lower chances of having that. So the standard error of the mean tells you how well your mean represents the center of the population. The standard error of the mean is very important because it's used as a basis for calculating confidence intervals. So you can see the calculation here. So a confidence interval is an interval. It has a start and an end. It's a range of values, as you can see. That's why you do two calculations. This is what you normally do when n is very low, when you have very small data sets, then this factor becomes higher. But that's not so important. You have to understand what it means, this confidence interval. So basically, what is it? The confidence interval has a center. That's the point that you see here. And that is the mean of your data set, the mean of your experiment. So what does the confidence interval say? It says that with 95% confidence, the actual center of the population will fall in this range. So you measure this, and you know that the actual mean of the population will fall somewhere here in that range. It's with 95% confidence, so that means that in 5 out of 100 experiments, it will not be the case, and you will end up here. So that's the experiments where all your individuals come from a tail. It's this one. But in 95% of the cases, the actual center of the population will fall in this interval. That's what it means. So, let's see if that was clear. So, I did a study. And based on that study, so I measured blood pressures from 100 people. I calculated a mean for these 100 people. And I calculated a 95% confidence interval. So this is the interval that you see here. So which of these statements is now true or false?